telco giant PLDT has unveiled one of the fastest home Wi-Fi services in the country that could reach up to 10,000 megabits per second. Its president, Manny Pangilinan, says aside from expanding their digital infrastructure, the group is also looking to grow in the transport sector. Jackie Pascual tells us more.
PLDT has launched its gigabit fiber service for residential subscribers as demand for faster internet grows. The new plans offer speeds of 1 gigabit per second up to 10 gigabits per second. That equates to around 10,000 megabits per second, much faster than the average Wi-Fi speed at homes, which is less than 100 Mbps.
When you bring in gigabit fiber, it really opens up a whole new ecosystem of possibilities. Most households today don't just have one device, they don't just have one person streaming, and they don't just have one service.
But what can one do with that speed? De La Cruz says some Filipinos are now requiring faster internet with the rise of smart homes, artificial intelligence, online devices, video streaming services, and more. The plan is bundled with premium video services as well as a cybersecurity protection program. It is initially available in select residential areas in Metro Manila and will soon roll out in Cebu and Davao.
Continuing to invest in building up that infrastructure and bringing it not only to the same level as other countries, but in fact, even further ahead.
We need to do more about expanding and raising the quality of our digital infra moving forward. And I think to get rid of our legacy elements of our infrastructure and getting to be all digital, practically all digital in terms of the composition of our infrastructure.
Pangilinan adds that aside from expanding its digital infrastructure, he is also eyeing to expand his rail business under the Metro Pacific Investments Corporation. He is considering taking over the stake of Ayala at LRT1 and may also submit a bid for the operations of MRT.
Possibility of being able to bid for MRT3. I understand the government might do what they did with NAIA, where they wanted to, because we submitted the original proposal.
Pangilinan is also forging stronger ties with former rival San Miguel Corporation President and CEO Ramon Ang. Their companies are now in talks for the merging of their toll businesses, saying that would be better than competing against each other.
We should combine our forces to do better for the Philippines, di ba?
Agreed.
So, and I think both of us can do better, at least in areas where you think it will produce more benefits by working together. One of his characteristics is that, why am I singing praises to Ramon? he's also a mechanic at heart.
Yeah.
So he likes to tinker, and I think he does a lot of checking up on his tollways. I don't do that.
Pangilinan, however, admits merging the toll businesses would be a challenge as expressways have separate franchises. One thing Pangilinan is quite sure is not bidding for the operations of the Metro Manila Subway, which he says is a business he is not familiar with. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Economic Zone Authority, or PEZA, reports a 19% jump in investments in the first 2 months of this year to 12.1 billion pesos, putting it on track to hit its 250 billion peso target this year. The agency says in its February meeting alone, it approved 28 new and expansion projects and expected to generate $661 million in exports while creating 3,580 direct employment. The Philippine government ramping up efforts to promote ease of doing business, the Fiscal Incentives Review Board hiking the investment capital threshold for projects handled by investment promotion agencies or IPAs from 1 billion pesos to 15 billion pesos, while those that exceed 15 billion will continue to fall under the purview of FIRB. The recent adjustment aligns with policy proposals in Congress which aim to empower IPAs with greater authority in granting incentives. All pending applications for tax incentives previously referred to the FIRB but do not meet the new investment capital threshold will be returned to the IPAs. The move expected to usher in more critical investments into the Philippines. Data show total investment capital from approved priority activities with incentives under the CREATE law has already reached 1.1 trillion pesos as of the end of 2023. State insurer GSIS reporting a 70% spike in its net income for 2023, its net income rising to over 113 billion pesos from just about $66 billion a year ago. This as its revenue increased by 33% to 311 billion pesos last year. GSIS vows to continue searching for yield and establish a diversified portfolio by securing new investment opportunities. The state insurer also reports its total assets increased 11% to 1.7 trillion pesos for 2023. Adapting to emerging technologies and maintaining Filipinos' signature resilient attitude, California-based employment agency CSI Professional says doing these would increase Filipinos' chances of landing a job abroad, particularly in the U.S. The Philippine Migrant Workers Department has said the number of overseas employment certificates it issued last year increased by 17% thanks to economies recovering from the COVID-19 pandemic.
Filipino. We don't stop learning in terms of skills.
We would probably need to enhance a bit the social media. We have to try to adapt and keep up with
keep
it.
Up.
Keep up. Go with the Gen Z. There you go. But one thing also with the Gen Z, they must also adapt or kind of go back or talk to their parents, talk to their aunts or relatives that who started in the industry 20 years or 20 some years ago. The attitude, the very resilient attitude, something that we could identify ourselves different and make ourselves distinct.
Nominations are open for the EY Entrepreneur of the Year Philippines 2024. As Andrea Taguinas tells us, a key consideration for this year's competition is an entrepreneur's ability to shape the country for the better in this post-pandemic era.
The SGV Foundation recently launched the search for the next Entrepreneur of the Year Philippines. The EOIP program honors the country's top entrepreneurs for their contributions to the economy and society to hopefully serve as role models for the next generations to come.
Since this was started in 2003, the EY Entrepreneur of the Year Philippines program recognizes the exceptional role played by entrepreneurs who are not only driven by their passion to innovate and reshape the business landscape, but also serve as inspiration and catalysts of change in their respective industries and communities.
In line with this year's theme, Shaping Opportunities, they are looking for entrepreneurs who are coming up with innovative ways to advance economic and national development in this post-pandemic era.
The COVID-19 and the pandemic, those are not excuses anymore. How do we not just build back better, but build forward fairer?
We all saw how we transformed some of our businesses to be more resilient after the pandemic. So now that we have found those opportunities, it's really time to shape those opportunities, but at the same time, really contribute to that DNA of contributing to the society.
We also highlighted the importance of using one's business as a tool to do good and not just to gain profit.
How do we treat our own people, our employees, people who are part of our supply chains and value chains? And then beyond that, also, what's your impact to the planet?
Philippine Stock Exchange President Ramon Monzon, who also partnered with SGV for the program, said that's also a new development in capital formation.
A lot of the investors, you know, are really focusing on companies with very clear ESG directions. You've got these investors now that invest in sustainability bonds, green bonds. No.
The five award categories this year are Master Entrepreneur, Small Business Entrepreneur, Young Entrepreneur, Woman Entrepreneur, and Technology Entrepreneur. From among these category winners will emerge the Entrepreneur of the Year 2024 Philippines, who will represent the country in the EY World Entrepreneur of the Year in Monte Carlo, Monaco in 2025. The nomination period will run until June, while the awarding ceremony is slated for October. Those interested can submit entries by visiting eoy.ey.com. Andrea Taguinas, ABS-CBN News.